हेलो क्लास, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 8, द फर्स्ट एम्पायर द मौर्यास। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट ऑल द थिंग्स दैट हैपेंड ड्यूरिंग दिस टाइम पीरियड एंड हु रूल्ड ओवर देयर। सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर द फर्स्ट एम्पायर द मौर्यास। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू गिव यू अ ब्रीफ इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट जनपदास एंड महाजनपदास। इन अ महाजनपदा और अ किंगडम The ruler had control over a smaller area, whereas an empire brings a number of kingdoms or mahajanpads under one ruler. So an empire and a kingdom were different for the following reason. The first one is, I want to tell you for a knowledge only, that empires were larger than kingdoms and were to be protected by big armies. Empires needed more resources than kingdoms. Empires also needed a larger number of officials to collect taxes and in order to meet the administrative expenses. So why I just want to told you these things? This one, because this one is the empire, not a kingdom. We are going to learn about the empire. The first empire, the Mauryas. So before this, I want to tell these things. So let's starting here with the first heading, that is emerging dynasties. So among the Mahajanpadas of the North India, Magadha, you can say the Magadha emerged as the most powerful of all. So this one is the most powerful, this Magadha. So the empire of Magadha was established under a dynasty when members of the same family become rulers one after one. The family is called dynasty. So in the family where the first one is means, for example, you can say if your father is a king, then the next king will be the you. And after that, your son, your successor will be the king. So in the dynasty, these things happen. This dynasty which established Magadha as the first ever empire in the history of India is known as Mauryan dynasty. So in this map we all can see the expand of Mauryan empire. The things that are in the brown color, this one is all the expand of Mauryan empire. Next, Alexander invasion. In about 326 BC, Alexander, the ruler of Macedonia, attacked northwestern India. Magadha was ruled by Dhananand. At that time, Magadha was ruled by Dhananand. Alexander's soldiers might have heard the tales of might of the Magadha army. Hence, they refused to advance then Vyas River. Alexander then decided to retreat, but left his Greek governors behind to rule and conquer territories. It was this invasion by Alexander which resulted in the downfall of Nandas and rise of Mauryas. From here it started. So how we have know about these things? The fact file that I want to tell you is Alexander came to be known as Alexander the Great because of his capability as an outstanding military commander, his diplomatic skills and spread of Greek culture, language and thought to all the conquered territories. The sources, there are two main books that serve as sources of information on the Mauryas. The first one is, here we can see the two main books. The first is Indica by Megasthenes. It tells us about the political, social and economic condition of the people during this period. Next one is Arthashastra by Kautilya. Arthashastra is, you can say, a treatise to how a government should function. Beside these two books, the Rock and the Pillar edicts also act as an important sources. So next, the Mauryan emperors. Who were the Mauryan emperors? After you can say the Dhananand, the king of Magadha, had a large and a powerful army. However, he was not popular among its subjects. Chandragupta, a young and ambitious warrior from Magadha, turned this thing to his advantage with the support of his chief advisor Chanakya. His chief advisor was Chanakya. We all have heard about the stories of Chanakya, a wise Brahmin and a scholar, we can say. So Chandragupta overview Dhananand, who was the last Nanda ruler. Next, he established control over Magadha, but one of the greatest empires of ancient India, and became the founder of the Mauryan Empire. He also defeated Seleucus Nicator. We all have heard this name, Seleucus Nicator. This one, a general of a Greek king, Alexander. So the Seleucus gave his daughter to marriage to Chandragupta and sent Megasthenes as an ambassador to his court. Chandragupta Maurya conquered Afghanistan, Balochistan and areas west of Indus. So the vast empire under Chandragupta's control stretched from Hindu Kush in the northwest to Bengal in the east, and from the Himalayas in the north to the Narmada in the south. He gave up his throne in 297 BCE and became a Jain monk. After this, when he became a Jain monk, next came the Bindusar. Chandragupta was succeeded by his son Bindusar. He also extended the Mauryan Empire by annexing territories reaching up to present-day Karnataka. So next, only the few parts of South India and Kalinga, present-day we can say this Odisha, were not part of Mauryan Empire. Rest there was the part of this Mauryan Empire. After his death in 273 BCE, he was succeeded by his son Ashoka. Next came the famous king, the Ashoka. The Emperor Ashoka is remembered as one of the greatest rulers of India. So the Mauryan Empire reached the peak of its glory under his rule. His numerous rock and pillars edicts spread over a large part of India gave invaluable information about his great ruler. This great ruler was very famous. Now also we all are following something, some of the political things that he created in his time. Ashoka's empire. How was his empire? Ashoka empire stretched from the Himalayas, Nepal and Kashmir in the north to Mysore in the south. From Afghanistan in the northeast to the banks of the river Brahmaputra in the east. There were several prosperous cities in the empire, including the capital city Pataliputra. The trade centers such as Takshila and Ujjain. Next, the people living in different parts of vast empire spoke different languages, they ate different kind of food and wore different kind of clothes. Nowadays these things are also seen. We all have seen from moving from one state to another that their culture is changed, their dressing sense is changed, their eating things, whatever they are eating, their eating style is changed. All the things are changed step by step moving to the other state. Next is Ashoka and the Kalinga War. This one is the famous war, Ashoka's Kalinga War. The Kalinga War is among most famous from fought off by Ashoka. He attacked Kalinga for two reasons. First one, the Ashoka's father Bindusar had previously attempted to win over Kalinga, but he had failed. That's why he wanted to attack. And second reason was that Kalinga was rich and prosperous kingdom with fertile lands, access to sea and land routes to South India and Southeast Asia. After conquering Kalinga, Ashoka stopped the expansion of his empire by war and concentrated on spreading Buddhism. He just followed and spreading. Ashoka's Dhamma. The first one, the Dhamma, the word came here. What does it mean? Dhamma in Sanskrit is Dharma, which literally means religious duty. But for Ashoka, it meant the right way. The Ashoka's Dhamma was not related to the worship of any god or performance of sacrifice. It was a code of conduct inspired by Buddha's teaching. He advocated non-violence, compassion and peace, but never forced his ideas on his subjects. He respected all the religions. and the edict set up by Ashoka explained the dharma. So the you can say these are the encryptions carry the following messages to his people. The first one is be tolerant of the religious, love and another, live in peace and harmony with another, follow the path of non-violence and do not harm any living thing. Be kind to all, including poor, servants, obey and respect elders, practice charity towards the poor. We also have to follow these things nowadays, because if we don't follow these things, that will just, we can say we are living, not living a human life, we are just living like that only. So these things should be followed by each and every person. We just have to polite to each and everyone. We just have to respect everyone. We have to obey our elders. So this one is the important thing. Now also we have to follow. Next is spread of dharma. To spread the message of dharma, he undertook the following things. First one, Ashoka appointed officials known as dharma mahamatras, whose went place to place to teach people about dharma. Nowadays we have heard about some saint is going somewhere and some satsang thing is happening somewhere. So these all are the things were done by these mahamatra. Ashoka also sent his officials to Syria, Egypt, Greece and Sri Lanka to spread dharma. He sent his son Mahendra and daughter Sangamitra to spread Buddhism. Next is, how was Mauryan administration? The administration of Mauryan time was very proper. The knowledge and information about the Mauryan administration can be gained from Chanakya's Arthashastra, Ashoka's pillars and edicts, and the Jain and the Buddhist text. Next is, the Mauryan empire was divided into four provinces and its capital was Pataliputra. The names of four provisional capitals were Tehsil in the east, Ujjain in the west, that Takshila, and Suvarnagiri in the south, Takshila in the north. Next is centralized administration. There are 18 departments called the Tithas and the president was called Mahamatya. Then the king was the head of the central administration. The king was assisted by the Mantri Parishad, the Council of Ministers. The Council of Ministers were there to assist king. The Council of Ministers included, in this we can say, the person who were important and included, first one Yuvraj, the prince, next one is Purohit, third one is Senapati, the commander of chief, next is Amatya. These all are the important person of this Council of Ministers. The capital city, Pataliputra. So there were many cities in the Mauryan Empire. According to that, an account in Indica by Megasthenes, the capital city of Pataliputra was the most impressive in its administration and layout. The Mauryan Emperor Chandragupta Maurya lived in the large palace in Pataliputra. The pillars in the palace were beautifully decorated. The city was surrounded with a high wooden wall and deep moats. Moats, you can say, this one is the word which means the moats are the word means a deep wide ditch usually filled with water surrounding a castle or fort for a defense purpose. So these are called the moats. The wall had 64 gates and 570 towers, and the city was also well connected with the different parts of empire. The administration was managed by 30 officials, and that was divided into 6 committees. Each committee looked after a special department, such as industries, foreigners, trade and commerce, sanitization, registration of birth and death, etc. Now also some things are happening from that time only. It is started and it is being followed now also. The fact file that I want to tell you, the first ever census was conducted during Mauryan rule. It recorded the number of people in the empire, their occupation and the caste. The next topic came here, the trade. This one is also the important topic. after Pataliputra, Takshila and Ujjain were the other two important cities. After Pataliputra, these two cities were very important. Next is roads and rivers, important for transport, were also established and maintained by Mauryans. Army. The Mauryan had a brilliant, well-occupied army. And they had a huge army of around, you can say, 6 lakh infantry. Infantry means foot soldier, those who walk. And next is 30,000 cavalry. You can say the soldiers, the horsemen are the cavalries. And 9,000 war elephants. Those are trained for the war. And you can say chariots were also there. A part of amount collected through the tax was paid as a salary to the soldier. Whatever the tax they have collected from there only, they used to provide salary to the soldiers. Next is taxation. Now also the tax is the important thing. The king appointed officers to collect taxes from farmers, herders and traders. Taxes were collected both in cash and a kind, you can say, in place of cash, people living in the forested regions were expected to provide elephants, timber, honey and wax to Mauryan officials as tributes. Next is the land tax was the major source of revenue. So below the picture given, you can see these are the punch marked coins. Next is art and architecture. So the modern art and architecture was appreciated right from the reign of Chandragupta, but it reached new heights under the rule of Ashoka. Ashoka attempted to promote Buddhism. He built many stupas and vihars. The various pillars edicts made by Ashokas were the object of wonder for many craftsmen. One such as Ashokan pillar is in Sarnath, which contains the loin capital. The national emblem of India is an adaptation of the loin capital. So the Indian currency also, we all have seen this, the loin in the currency, and all the important Indian documents have the symbol of the loin capital on them. This symbol is very important. Currency and all are the important documents having this sign, the loin capital of Ashoka. The Ashoka Ashok Charak also appears of the Indian flag. Ashok Chakra, we have seen this chakra that is here, also we have seen on the Indian flag. This one is the pillar, Ashoka's pillar, and these all are the edicts, something written on a stone or wall. Next came the decline of Mauryas. How this empire became to decline? The Mauryan Empire gradually became to decline after the death of Ashoka in 232 BCE. The many reasons led to weakening of the Mauryan Empire. First one is the weak successor of Ashoka could not control an empire as large as the Mauryan Empire was that time. The internal rivalries and disunity, you can say, unity was not there, added to the weakening of the administration. Corrupt officials affected to the administration. And expenses to maintain such a large empire and its army were too much, which could not be met. Because all the administration, whatever the Ashoka was doing, was not well followed by his successors. Next is emergence of Sangha dynasty. The last Mauryan ruler, Brihadrath, was killed in 185 BCE by his own commander-in-chief, Pushyamitra Sangha, who later founded the Sangha dynasty. So, next, other dynasties that come after this. So, the Sanghas were followed by another dynasty known as Kanvas, and the western parts of central India were ruled by the Satvanas for about 400 years. Around 1700 years ago, a new ruling family known as Vakatas became powerful in central and western India. Many other kingdoms and dynasties emerged after that, but none could match the splendor of the mighty Mauryas for the next 1,000 years to come. Next year came elsewhere at the same time, about 24,000 years ago, the Chinese emperors built the Great Wall of China to protect the northern front line of the empire from the pastoral people. The wall is about, you can say, 64,000 kilometers long and is made of stone and brick with a road along the top. Several thousand people worked to build the wall. The watchtowers were also built all around at the distance of about 100 to 200 meters to keep a check over the enemies. Here, the below picture is the Great Wall of China.